Hi all and welcome back. So in today's tutorial we'll be looking on one more topic called as database view. So we will try to understand what is database view, okay, why there is a need of database view, okay, what is the architect behind this, how we can implement it with one example. Okay, so it's like a complete in-depth explanation of database view. So let's go to the ServiceNow docs first and try to understand what is the database view. So it defines, according to ServiceNow docs, a database view defines table joins for reporting purpose. So we understood one thing, okay, that it's kind of join between two tables, okay. You must have seen, if you're familiar to SQL statement, it's like left join, inner join, right join, all the things, right? So it's join. And we do join in order to get the fields of both the table, okay. Okay, so from both the table, okay. So that's the definition. So let's try to understand. So for example, you have a requirement, okay, where you a client want to create a report, okay, on incident table to see what is the maximum resolution time for an incident, okay. So for that, he went to an incident form, and on incident, if you are aware, there's no incident, no field which can give you the information how much time exactly the incident has taken to get resolved from start to end, okay. So being a developer, okay, we know there is a concept called metric instance, okay. The metric instance table stores the data in a timestamp, okay, key of a state transition, okay, from which it's already defined on incident table. So we gave the recommendation on the same and we went to the report, okay. So let's go to the report, and on report we create a new report, okay. We know the problem statement, we want to find the maximum resolution time. So we went on the, let's give it the name as resolution time incident report, okay. So this is our report, okay. Now it's the report, and we will go with the table, and we know the table name is metric_instance. If people are not aware about this table, just go and read about this table. It's very important. You can create a separate rule, metric definition, we can see, to define a metric instance, okay. So we went to the metric instance, okay. We will go with the bar graph, okay, for this particular example. And let's do business duration, let's do group by ID, because we want to accumulate all the records, because it will create one record from new to in progress, it will create in progress to hold, it will create another record. Whenever the state transition happened, it will create a new record. So we want to sum up all the record. So we will do group by ID so that all the incident will get sum up. Okay, we will do group by ID, and we'll do group by ID, and let's do a sum, okay, and sum on which particular field we have to do. So let's do the sum on duration, okay, and let's do the next thing, okay. So as you can see over here, we got a report right now. I will just minimize this out. So we got a report right now, but we want the report on incident, right? But we can see over here, it's incident also, it's problem also, and others also, because this particular metric instance is created on the task table, okay. So we can add a filter condition, okay, where we can give from table is incident, okay, and we run the report, and now we got all the record from the incident table itself, okay. So this is how. Now client is pretty happy, okay, he see the report and he's like, oh wow. Now if he ask you, okay, I want to see for which particular assignment group it belongs to, or he wants to get the information of assignment group, or he wants to just filter out this resolution time only for one group. So let's see if I want to do group, something like group, okay. There is nothing called group, but on incident table we know there is a group. This happens because on metric instance table, the incident, the field which stores the incident reference is a document ID field, okay. So it's not possible to dot walk to a incident field. Here is the limitation for this report, okay, on a metric table. So we have to create a database view in order to fetch the feeds from the incident table. So let's see how it can be done. Okay, so what we will do, we'll first try to understand how it impacts. Okay, so let's do this. So I have created a flow diagram. It's not there. Let's do. So in this particular thing, there are three tables involved. Okay, first is metric definition. Okay, I will give the name metric definition, and you can define it for anything. Okay, definition. The second is metric instance, and the third one is incident. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to define the relationship between these three tables so that we will get a complete database view. Okay, so how it will work, so we have, you can consider this as three tables as we mentioned, right? Let's give a space between them. So this is metric definition. Consider this as metric instance, and just bear with my cases, right? Incident table, okay? Incident table, okay? So now with this particular three tables, okay, if we collab this three table, then we can create a database view. So how we will do that? Okay, so this three will get combined to form a database view. Do it properly. Okay, so before that, okay, before bringing, these are the separate entities, right? We have to define a relationship between these two. So we went and we analyzed. So what we analyzed, that creating a relationship can form based on a field, right, which is common in both the tables. So you have to just get the fields which are common in both the table, and you have to define the relation between that. So we found in metric instance and metric definition, so we found that definition, okay. So first of all, what we want? We want from definition, table should be incident, okay. We want table to be incident. So this is a criteria which we want to define. So let's go one by one, okay. So first of all, we want to define a relation between these two tables, okay. So for this two table, we found that if you go and check on the table also, that the definition field on this table is equal to the sysid of this metric instance table, okay. So we can say this table definition is equal to instance table sysid. So we got the relation between these two tables, okay. Now we went to the other table, okay, on incident and metric instance. So what is common between these two tables? That in metric instance, ID of metric instance is equal to sysid of incident table. So these are the relationship which we got, okay. Based on this relationship, now we can create a database view, okay. So how to create a database view? This must be clear to you, okay. You will understand it once we try to create a database view out of it. So what we will do, we'll go over here. Let's type a database view. Forget about this report. It's of no use for us. Database view. Okay. In database view, let's create a new database view. Okay. Let's give it an incident metric database view demo. Okay. Or I will simply give NCMT metric, incident metric, okay. So this is a table, and I will zoom out somewhere, and we will give it a name, incident metric database. And you can, in the similar way, this is just an example. You can create it, create n number of things, n number of database view out of this. Okay, you just have to define the relationship. That's more important. So I will save it out. Okay, now once we save, we get a related list view tables. Okay, so now we have to define the tables which are involved in this. Okay, so the first one we will go one by one. Okay, so the first one is in the metric definition. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to go and select that table out first of all. So we'll go metric. Sorry, I made a spelling mistake. Metric underscore definition. Okay, this is a table. Now you have to define one prefix. Okay, it's like a SQL join. Okay, so which will act like a what we call attribute to define the where condition. Okay, so metric definition, I will get simply take the initial, so it will be MD. Now what condition we wanted for this? The table equal to incident table. Okay, so we will define the same condition. So in where clause we will be like MD underscore is in database view whenever you are working. Okay, we do the dot working. Okay, in the similar way when you are working on database view, you have to replace dot with underscore. Okay, it will be MD underscore incident, MD underscore table. What we want, table equal to, we want incident, right? So this is all what we did. We have selected the first table out of it. Okay, we have defined a prefix called MD. You can define anything, and we have just defined MD dot, dot is replaced by underscore equal to incident. The first thing is done. Okay, now let's move to the next. So what was the next one? The next one was on a metric instance, right? So on metric instance, what we have to do? We have to define this relationship, definition and society wala, or relationship, right? So let's create a new one. So here we will give a table name as metric underscore instance. Okay, now let's give it a prefix MI. I'm giving it as MD for metric definition, MI for metric instance, and you can define. Now the definition was like the definition of this. Okay, metric definition is equal to the society of metric instance. You have to do the same. So MI underscore definition. Okay, equal to MD underscore says underscore ID. So definition of a metric instance will reference to the sys ID of metric definition in simple words. Okay, so this is done. We have completed this part also. This part first we have completed this, now we have completed this. Now the third part is remaining. Okay, only so for that we will create a new one again. And in this, what is the ID of metric instance equal to sys ID of incident, right? So let's define that. So that now the table will be incident, right? We will define a prefix called INC. Okay, and now what we have to do, MI underscore ID, ID of metric instance equal to sys ID of incident. Pretty easy, right? We submit it out, and guess what? This is all done. Okay, we have created a database view. We have defined a relationship for a database view. Now let's see if it works. I will save it out once again. So now we have defined the three view tables. So the first one is a metric definition. In metric definition, we have defined with order 100. I've just given the order, and we have defined the MD dot table equal to, we want incident table only. Then we went to metric instance. In metric instance, we have defined that the definition of metric instance equal to the sysid of the metric definition. And the third one is incident table. In incident table, we define the ID of metric instance equal to the incident sysid. Okay. Now let's come at the top and let's try it out. Okay. Let's see if it works. And now you can see we got a view, okay, which is an incident matrix view, okay. And you can see we are getting it, we will get now the fields from incident matrix also, plus we will get the fields from incident table. So now let's try to create a reporter around this, okay. So we'll go to reports. Okay, I will zoom in. So reports, let's go to create new. Okay, and we will give it a name, metric incident demo. Okay, and we will select the source table as now u underscore, what was that, incident empty, right? This was the table. Okay, let's go with the same flow. Next, we'll select the bar graph. Okay, next we'll group by, now you will see the additional fields. Okay, we'll do group by ID and we will do sum. Okay, sum based on duration. Duration from metric instance and run. Okay. Now we got again, because this, now we have followed the same step, but you can see there are no problem incident because we have given the metric definition as incident only, right? So it has removed the problem one. Okay. Plus now if I want to do the, if I want to check for any assignment group, okay. Now what I can do, I can simply go to assignment group S and I can take any database, for example. Okay, and if I run, so there are no records for database group, but in this way we can see now the assignment group filter also. So this is the importance of database view. Hope you like this video. Please like, follow, subscribe. Okay, please drop comments so that I can create videos based on your session. This was also from one of my subscriber. Okay, till then, stay safe, stay happy and have a nice day. Goodbye.